The National Black Programming Consortium has been around for more than 30 years. It's a public media organization that was created to ensure that the stories of the African American community were on public broadcasts and makers received the kind of support that they need to make that possible. So we did professional development training. We do funding. We provide mentoring services to filmmakers. We kind of help usher that content onto public broadcasting. But in the last 5 or 6 years, with the way the internet has impacted the way content is created and published and distributed, we've kind of shifted to these next media technologies and started concentrating training makers in this technology so that they wouldn't be left behind in terms of getting their content seen and create even more avenues and opportunities for their content to reach the desired audience. The Public Media Corps is a project of the NBPC. It's a beta that was started about 3.5 years ago, influenced by this push in the country to ensure that there was broadband access in all communities, including the most underserved communities. And we saw this opportunity to use that as to drive underserved communities using technology to public media.
The Digital Media Arts Club is an after-school program that was created to get students re-engaged in school by using digital media. We felt that a lot of our kids were digital natives, but unfortunately, because of the lack of resources or a lack of knowledge about how to use the resources effectively, they weren't able to use different variations of technology in the classroom. So we figured we would do an after-school program to allow them to further explore digital media and technology in a more engaging environment or a more conducive environment for them, which was in schools. And now we've actually moved beyond after-school programs. Some of our programs are during the school day, and then some of them are in community centers.
In Washington, D.C., we actually train Howard University students to go into the schools and to our sites as trainers and mentors.
And basically, my objective is to go in these classrooms, connect with these kids, mentor them, and teach them things in the digital media arts field. So what I do, I keep them updated with the new technology, whether it's, you know, film, or teach them basic techniques, whether, you know, within the film field, or, you know, teach them, you know, also simple things such as creating websites, developing, you know, ideas and techniques, visualizing, showing them the process of getting production done.
The experiences that they're getting through the Digital Media Arts Club is definitely rewarding, and it's good for us to see the impact that we're making.
It's actually more than what I thought it was going to be. You know, it's more than just me being in the classroom teaching kids. It's actually helped me develop as a person, helped me understand, you know, that certain age group, which is around 13 to 18, in a different light. And it also helped me to realize that it's more than, you know, me being a part of the program, but it showed me how compassionate I was for the youth to help them personally, because I, as much as I made an impact on them, they made an impact on me.
I would like to see this program, whether it's an after-school program, whether it's integrated into a journalism program, in-school journalism program, or a course study. But I would like to see it in as many communities across the country as possible, because I think that, you know, we're dealing with a population, they're digital natives. And so they process, a lot of them process information visually and through manipulation of technology. So in the program, we are teaching them technology. We're kind of introducing them to new technology. They adapt to it very quickly, but it's about getting them to go deeper in terms of their use. So we're trying to create deeper patterns of use in terms of how they engage and interact with technology. So I would like to see us encourage that among young people, you know, all across the country. Some schools could have an environment in which there's such a close integration of technology in the classroom and in the way it's used in their homes that is a natural. But in some communities, like in some of our schools, they're newly renovated, and so they're just getting extensive computer labs. But when we started, sometimes we had to bring our own laptops. So the technology isn't as integrated. And one of the things that we are going to start to offer, and some of our schools have agreed to this, is doing the professional development days for the teachers to go into the schools and teach them to use some of the same technology we're teaching their students. Because we really want to help them transition from the club into the classroom and show the connection between, you know, it's like fun meeting function in terms of the technology. It's fun, it allows you to be creative, and at the same time, there are clear applications to their course studies.
In the future, I'm hoping the Digital Media Arts Club is actually more than a club, but it's integrated into the classroom so that we finally get to a point where teachers are using technology and students are engaged in that way. And that hopefully we bridge that gap so that the teachers are prepared and the students are excited, and learning is definitely a new, exciting environment for our students.